Greetings, Guardians. My name is Byf from RFN. Welcome back to How to Improve Destiny. And joining me again on this episode, we have the wonderful MesaSean. Sean, say hi.
Hello, Guardians.
And in this episode, we are going to be discussing the Iron Banner and some Crucible bounties. Continuing in the sort of same theme of how do you improve the Crucible, in this particular one, we're going to be talking about how to make the Crucible a bit more approachable for new players. We're going to talk about our thoughts on the Iron Banner and how to, generally speaking, improve the bounty system. So I'm just going to go ahead and throw this first question to Sean, which is, what did you think of the new revamped Iron Banner that happened 2 weeks ago?
In a nutshell, the key modifier, I think, for this time was fun. It was a lot of fun. You know, the first one, I felt it was impossible for solo players and clearly was not any balance issues with regards to power really mattering. And I noticed early on when my Hunter was level 29, I was downing 26s and 27s rather easily, and then noticing a lot more difficult times to take down those 29s and 30s. And on the flip side, because they gave us incentives and I was able to get a gauntlet from the Iron Banner by Saturday, then I was up to rank 30, and then I clearly noticed that it was way more competitive when running into other fellow 30s or 29s, and then just destroying anyone that was, say, level 25, 26. So I think they definitely nailed it with regards to the power matters and the incentives to, you know, bringing your best gear, and the higher level clearly has the advantage.
Mm. It definitely, I will say one thing, there is definitely a huge amount of emphasis now on the fact that there is such a difference. I mean, I was running into various level 21s and 22s and lower levels on my first few days of Iron Banner, and there were occasions where, you know, I'd have a very powerful, fully upgraded Hawk Moon in my inventory, and I would just one-shot people because Hawk Moon.
Yeah.
It's, you know, the kind of power matter stuff is really, really being emphasized. It's crazy now, the spiel that you can have about that kind of stuff really... It does matter. It's now so significant that I feel as though there is a good balance between actual balanced gameplay and, meaningful level advantages. So I think it's done really well on that. You also touched on the reward system, Sean. I gotta agree with you, dude. Like, the rewards for this Iron Banner were so much better. Like,
it was, I mean, finally the incentives were there. Because when I looked at what Lord Saladin was offering, Saladin, I always mess it up, was offering
Lord
last
Saladin
time, I said, yeah, I was like, well, what's the real incentive? But as soon as I saw, okay, wait, I need that gauntlet, oh God, I want that shader, you know, and it really gave you something to strive for. And at the same time, I noticed, as opposed to standard Crucible control, that even when I was playing solo, everyone was trying to play the objective, which was very, very... It was so much better in terms of not going in there solo and people just walking by me when I'm capping B flag. I'm saying, excuse me, could you help me cap this flag, please? So really encourage, you know, people to play the objective to go for the win. And at the same time, the medallion system, did kind of reward you a bit if you lost. And okay, keep playing, get that win, and you can get back that XP. Encourage you to stay in it and not give up.
Absolutely. And I mean, on top of that, there is just the fact that they really figured out, just pinpointed the causes of every problem from the last Iron Banner, I guess. The medallion system is a really great example of that, but also it's just, I mean, you talk about it becoming like fun, and that is a key principle that I think changed for it, you know? The Iron Banner previously felt like a grind and just a huge Cirrus Fest. And admittedly, this one is too, because they still haven't nerfed the damn thing, but it's a far better Cirrus Fest, because, frankly, hand cannons are now much more common in the meta, and it's also the case that you had a lot of people with these level advantages using hand cannons and other weapons that took a bit more skill, but were more rewarding, you know? So,
right.
I mean, for example, one of our guys in our raid group, a little bit Goki, he played it to level, to a reputation rank 5 on all 3 of his guardians. So that's a Hunter, a Titan, and a Warlock, and Guy, his Grimoire score, we now call it his no-life meter, but Guy's epic at doing this kind of stuff. And, you know, the fact that it was that replayable is really, really a good indication. So I can't knock the Iron Banner at this point. It's just really good. It's got where it needs to be. The fact that they're offering gear that lets people raid is a really nice stepping stone into Crota's End. And, yeah, some of the other stuff they sold, like the Fusion Rifle, I use that now currently in a Titan build that I'm running, and it's really quite good.
I'm definitely looking forward to, you know, obviously the next Iron Banner. It's clear that Bungie does listen and makes changes. You know, I always tell a lot of people this, listen, this is not Bungie, I mean, this is not Destiny 2 or 3. This, you know, this is their first time. They're feeling their way out. Let them make mistakes, but they're learning from their mistakes. And, you know, with that, I'm looking forward to the trials of Osiris. I think they'll, you know, they've learned from their Iron Banner. They'll learn, you know, from trials of Osiris. And hopefully that might even go off without a hitch first try. Who knows? You know, we'll see.
Absolutely. And I mean, there is a whole lot of potential for that.
Yeah.
I really like the fact that there is, just in the future, something we can touch on very briefly, a new emerging thing that could result in an entirely separate 3v3 meta. But I'm not going to go into that because I don't want to bore the audience with use of words. I don't know. But yeah, let's get on to our talk about the bounty system, our spiel about how to make stuff more approachable. And I'm going to go ahead and say that the majority of the suggestions for these are Sean's because of a combination of illness and various other things going on in my life on my end. So yeah, Sean, I'm going to let you take all this away, you being the MVP.
Sure. Okay, thank you. Yeah, I was just throwing it out there to, well, you know, I've run into a lot of friends, you know, subscribers, people just in general who have a little bit of a fear of the Crucible because, you know, it is difficult. It takes some getting used to. And I feel like right now the bounties somewhat don't reward the entry-level players or people who don't have as much experience, but they do reward kind of the seasoned veterans. So let's say someone is an expert, at, you know, at the Crucible, defeating 25 warlocks, you know, 25 titans, you know, that's a no-brainer. But I feel like if they had a tiered system where you could do something for the newer players, which might be, okay, so like if you capture 10 control zones, you get 2,000, okay? But if you maintain two control zones at once for 2 minutes, then you get an extra 500 each 2 minutes or something like that. Or give you an incentive to defeat like X amount of guardians while defending a control point. You know, you had brought up before about something more. It would be like a weekly thing, where it would give something for the real pros and the Crucible experts to strive for. I really, really like that idea.
Like the wonderful thing about making that so like a weekly bounty is that it also it implements two systems, as well as having, you know, the bounty itself and whatever rewards you might throw in of that. It implements a ladder that players can look at in terms of the bounty and tiering it up. So not only do we have the tier system that we just discussed of, you know, the objectives themselves are progressive, but they're ranked progressively against other bounties. So, you know, when you're slightly more skilled at the Crucible, take a look at these two intermediate boundaries, and then you're like, yeah, I guess I could do those. And then, you know, as you go up, you eventually find the head honcho, the weekly bounty, which would be something really hard to do in the Crucible. So something like get a Mark of the Unbroken, get the Sum of All Tears medal, you know, double kill something with a throwing knife, I don't know, you know, get those kind of crazy medals that only the really, really good players are going to get. And those act not only as the top rung of the ladder for people who are looking to climb it, but they also act as the aspirational goal. They act as that one thing where you can say, one of these days, I'm going to accomplish that, and when I do, I'm going to get that sweet reward. So it's definitely something that I think could be implemented with quite a bit of success. Like, if you think about it, now, we discussed this a little bit earlier, and our commentary got deleted for this, which makes me super sad, but I'm kind of glad now, because I realize that doing something like that makes a little bit like the equivalent in PvP of a Nightfall Strike, if you have good enough rewards for it. So, I mean, we were discussing earlier the potential for, if you defeat the bounty for that week, maybe you get a legendary engram drop, or you get something along the lines of a, you know, a unique shader, or a unique ship, or a unique emblem, something along those lines to give people really neat rewards.
Right, something to strive for, but not boost for, so not like a guaranteed exotic or something like that. Because then, you know, like you said, they could just go in, like you said on the previous commentary that got deleted, they could just go into Rumble, three people, because obviously Rumble won't let a party of six in there, but, you know, go in there and boost for it. But something, yeah, something that they could say, hey, you know what, I want that shader, or that, you know what, that particular ship, you know, looks cool, or you know what, I can get, this week it's a legendary chest engram, you know, and my one particular character, that's something that I could use, or something like that.
Exactly. And I mean, you know, again, it's, we can talk about this again in sort of the context of stepping stones and rungs on ladders, you know, these things, they give you different mobile ways of improving your characters. So if I was going to start a new hunter, and, you know, I'm pretty good with a hunter, but I need legendary armor so I can go and raid, well, it's nowhere near as much of a challenge now, because what I can simply do is jump in and, you know, grab some wonderful legendary gear through Crucible if I'm that good. So,
yep.
You know, adding more options in terms of mobility and how you get legendaries is good as long as the challenge is up there. Because, I mean, let's face it, when you run a Nightfall or something like that, you're doing something that is pretty tough, even if you cheese it. So, if it's a similar level of challenge in Crucible terms, then I feel like it's fine, because you're not oversaturating with a huge number of legendary engrams and such. And, you know, it doesn't cheapen the experience of the game, doesn't necessarily speed it up, but it gives players who are really good at other things more options.
Right. You know, so the key is really, in a nutshell, is to keep the seasoned players, give them something a little new to do, as well as bring in more of the unseasoned players and give them some more tangible, realistic types of bounties to, you know, to actually strive for.
Absolutely. And I mean, you know, the reasoning behind no exotic and whatnot, I think, is definitely something that's very, very important. And there is a good reason why I think this separates a bounty system for exotics from something like, say, the Trials of Osiris, which, again, is 3v3. You can only get in a certain number of times unless, you know, you're really successful constantly. And there is a good reason for all this separation, but it means that we just have a lot of potential different ways charted out that we can improve the bounty system and be careful about it at the same time.
Definitely.
But yeah, I think that is practically going to resolve this spiel, this little talk on bounties. In the meantime, though, guys, go ahead and subscribe to MesaSean's channel. It's going to be in the description as well as in the end reel, so stick around for that. And in the meantime, Paradasia Restra, I'll see you starside.
Stay beautiful, Guardians.